Hey guys, it's time to do the most wanted camera comparison. I'm talking about the Galaxy A70 versus the Galaxy S10 Plus. The real life camera test is here. We have the Galaxy A70 with triple cameras at the back. It has a main 32MP camera, an 8MP ultrawide camera, and a 5MP depth sensor. The Galaxy A70 has a single 32MP camera on the front. There is no mention of OIS or EIS in this phone. It's equipped with the Pro Mode, Live Focus Mode, Super Slow-Mo, Slow-Mo, and it can shoot 4K videos too. The Galaxy S10 Plus has a 12MP main camera, a 12MP telephoto shooter, and a 16MP ultra-wide camera. It has a 10MP camera and an 8MP camera on the front. Galaxy S10's cameras are optically stabilized. S10 Plus is the most powerful smartphone in the Samsung Galaxy family at the moment. Its camera application is feature-rich. It definitely has all those features you see in the Galaxy A70 and some exclusive features like 4K at 60fps and 4K from the front camera. I am calling this a real-life camera test because I'm not a professional photographer and I have shot these images just as an average smartphone user would do. I have shot images in my house and out in a park. I have tried my best to make it the most appropriate camera comparison. In this comparison, you will see the following comparisons. Now, why I am doing this camera comparison? The Galaxy S10 Plus is a phone that will cost you nearly 1000 to 1200 USDs. On the other hand, the Galaxy A70 comes in at a price tag of merely $500. So a phone that costs half of the Galaxy S10, how does it exactly stack up against its camera? That's exactly what I wanted to find out, and I'm sure many of you want the same. This is going to be a very, very detailed comparison as I have shot images in all the possible environments and all the modes. So hold your horses and watch this camera comparison with all the patience you have. Before you start, please hit that subscribe button and hit that bell icon too, and let's start it now. So while taking the very first slow-mo shot on the Galaxy A70, my friend pushed this cutter all the way into his hand and it hit him really bad. But we did not give up on making this comparison. In the first phase, I captured a lot of super slow-mo videos. First of all, I would like to tell you that the S10 Plus has the auto shooting mode for the super slow-mo videos. It can detect motion and capture them. The A70 lacks this feature. On the A70, you can't really manipulate a super slow-mo video because you have only 0.2 seconds to shoot. You have to be extremely accurate with the motion and your capture button on the Galaxy A70. The 960fps super slow-mo shots were really crispy on the Galaxy S10 Plus. The resolution was not up to the mark on the Galaxy A70. What I like here is the fact that the Galaxy A70 at least has this super slow-mo mode. I hope that Samsung adds the auto mode for super slow-mo shots in near future. I am totally in love with the super slow-mo shots and I will definitely do a separate video on these shots. After this, I took the slow-mo shots and they were really nice on both the phones. Once again, the details and sharpness were great on the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. They were definitely ahead of the Samsung Galaxy A70. Shooting slow-mo shots on both the phones is a real fun. I actually enjoyed the slow-mo shots on the Galaxy A70 as much as I enjoyed them on the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. Now take a look at the rear videos now. I would like to tell you that I have completely mixed up these videos, so please bear with me on that. This first video is in the 4K resolution from the Samsung Galaxy A70 and it's really impressive. The video is shaky because I was holding two phones and I totally forgot about taking the shots one by one, but you can see the video quality anyway. The 4K video from the Galaxy S10 Plus looks really neat and clean, because this time I was holding a single phone only. Loved the shot from the Galaxy S10 Plus. And here is a 4K 60fps shot from the Galaxy S10 Plus. It's shaky, as I mentioned earlier that I was holding two phones at the same time. I do plan on doing a separate video on this. Here is a 1080p 60fps video from the Samsung Galaxy A70. I will leave the overview of this video on you. And here is a 1080p 60fps video from the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. Super steady and impressive. Lastly, here is a 1080p video from the Samsung Galaxy A70. Not very stable, as this was shot alone. It is better than most of its competitors though. Hey guys, this is a front camera video test between the Samsung Galaxy A70 and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. This video will also give you an idea about the mic recording quality of these phones. I am out in the bright sunshine, so you can see all the elements around me. Unfortunately, there are no clouds today, so you cannot really be sure about the dynamic range from these phones. But here is the video quality for that matter. Let me know in the comment section down below which phone's front video do you find better. Hey guys, this is a front camera video test between the Samsung Galaxy A70 and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. This video will also give you an idea about the mic recording quality of these phones. I am out in the bright sunshine, so you can see all the elements around me. Unfortunately, there are no clouds today, so you cannot really be sure about the dynamic range from these phones. But here is the video quality for that matter. Let me know in the comment section down below which phone's front video do you find better. It's time to take a look at the pictures. In the very first indoor selfie, A70 produces a soft picture. It beautifies it more. The Galaxy S10 Plus tries to keep the picture a bit natural with a warm tone. In the live focus selfie, the A70 once again softens the picture. A70's picture looks good, but S10 Plus's picture is a bit saturated, which is why it looks natural. Both phones have a great picture, but the Galaxy S10 Plus's picture is slightly more detailed. Colors look well balanced to me. The S10 Plus is softening the color of my shirt, while the A70 keeps it balanced. Details on the S10 Plus are good once again. Once again, a great picture on both the phones. I like my shirt in the A70 and my face is more detailed in the S10 Plus. For the selfies, it's totally your own choice. The depth effect of the Galaxy S10 Plus is obviously better. If you like that brightness and beautification in the selfies, you may go with the Galaxy A70 for natural looking selfies. S10 Plus is the way to go. And here is a selfie in the night without the flash and then with the flash turned on. S10 Plus takes a better photo with the flash. I think I forgot to clean the lens of my S10 Plus in this one. That's why it has a flare. S10 has a saturated picture again. There is a yellowish effect on the A70's picture. Both phones in their place have a good picture. This time the colors in the A70's picture look better. S10's blur is really great. The S10 Plus is bringing in appropriate light while the Galaxy A70 is making it a bit dull. Take a look at the background, which is more vibrant in the S10's picture. A70 is darkening the face while trying to add that depth effect. S10 Plus is keeping it really nice. Now here is a picture with two different focus points. The S10 Plus clearly nails here, but keeping in view the price bracket of the Galaxy A70, it has a really great picture. If you just compare it to the flagships of other Android phone makers, you will find A70's picture better than many. I think I'll go with the A70's picture as it has better visibility of the focused object. Colors and shadows of the S10's picture are really deep. The sky is a bit dark in the A70's picture and a bit bright in the S10 Plus's picture. Shadows in the S10 Plus's photos are really nice. The S10 Plus has a too sharp image, which makes it lovely. A70 is not that far behind. The white color looks great in the S10 Plus. A70 is making the whites a bit dull. Shadows on the S10 Plus are too deep. The A70 clearly wins this one. The reason is S10 Plus is changing the color of this floor. The real color can be seen in the A70's picture. S10 may have a very detailed picture but messes up the colors. Look at the purple color's depth and the edge detection in the S10 Plus's picture. It's just a superb shot. I won't call A70's picture bad, it's also very close to the S10 Plus. This picture without a doubt is looking great on the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. Now here are the pictures that I took outside in a park. In all these pictures, the Galaxy S10 Plus had a slightly warmer tone, which justified the real colors of the park. The Galaxy A70's cool effect on pictures did not look bad either. I personally like the pictures of the Galaxy A70 because it did not just yellow the pictures. And here we have the wide and the ultra wide shots. In all these shots, the colors, highlights and details in the S10 Plus's pictures were very apt. The Galaxy A70 took considerably good pictures. They were at least the best in the Galaxy A series so far. And this is a building from the ultra wide camera. First of all, I switched to wide, then took the shot at 4x zoom, and lastly I took the shot at 8x zoom. In the zoom shots, the Galaxy A70 completely lost it. S10 Plus keeps the picture crunchy and crispy even in the zoomed images. It's time to take a look at the night shots. The Galaxy A70 most of the times blurs out the night shots. S10 Plus keeps them intact. I am definitely blown away from the night photo performance of the Galaxy S10 Plus. But if we compare the Galaxy A70 to its lower siblings, the phone does a good job. I believe you just need to have your hand super steady in order to take good shots in the night from the Galaxy A70. I took a number of indoor pictures in the balanced light and then in the extremely low light. In the indoor shots, the Galaxy S10 Plus produced slightly warmer images once again. The A70 lacked details in the indoor pictures. Shadows on the Galaxy S10 Plus looked great once again. S10 Plus's edge detection was also better. Overall, the Galaxy A70 did not take bad photos at all. It is well worth it. Lastly, I took this low light shot without the flash and with the flash. Without the flash, I find S10 better, and with the flash, I find the A70 better. It's time to take a look at the verdict now. The Galaxy S10 Plus has one of the best cameras out there, and it is justified for that hefty price tag it comes with. Keeping in view Galaxy S10's half price that the Galaxy A70 comes in, this phone does a tremendous job. The upper mid-ranger Galaxy A70 can be used as your daily photography driver too, and as always, it boils down to your personal preference in the end. Let me know about your thoughts in the comment section down below. That's all with this camera comparison. I hope you guys find this video really useful. If you liked it, thumbs up. If you loved it, subscribe to my channel. I will see you in the next one really soon.